Hello and welcome to a brand new tutorial, the part in your day where you come and you look for help on YouTube, and I am here to help. So today we're going to be doing a small little forest scene that you can see right here. It's pretty basic. We use Arboro to generate two different type of plant models. This little sprout right here, and this wheat rush type thing right here. So we're going to be using Arboro to generate those, bring them into Blender, and creating this small little scene right here. It's just a tiny little particle system, not much to it, with a simple forest background and a sun lamp. So that's pretty much it. So let's get into the tutorial and start creating your own little forest. Okay, so like I said, we're gonna be using Arboro for this first part to generate those two different type of plant models. So I have Arboro loaded up. If you don't have Arboro, go ahead and head over to arboro.sourceforge.net. All right. And there you can look at the website. All these trees are the pre-generated trees that you can use. So we got our little bit of grass there, and then we're gonna be using this barley. That's the name of it, barley. So we're using barley in the shape grass. All right, and then to download it, you'd go to the project site and click on download. So, we got Arboro here. Let's go ahead and open. And in your folder where the Arboro file was downloaded, you can come to the trees section in that folder. And you have all these different trees already loaded up. So, we know the first one is the shaved grass. So all I have to do is go ahead and open that up. And you can change settings if you want, if you know your way around Arboro, but it's good how it is right now. So all you need to do then is select create and export tree. And for Blender, since we're going to be using Blender, you're going to want to change it to a wavefront OBJ so Blender can open that file. And if you're going to add in for trees and stuff, you normally click the UV coordinates for stems, that way you could put a bark texture to it. But it's all gonna be a grass material, so we don't need to worry about that. And then just choose where you want to download it to, and go ahead and hit start. And that should be good. So I'll just put mine on the desktop, so we can see here. Let's name that grass.obj. All right, and make sure everything's good. Go ahead and click start, and it's pretty fast. So now, if we hop into Blender, just go ahead and delete the default cube, and we'll import a wavefront obj. Then on the desktop, you just select the model, double click, and it's pretty small, but there it is. There's our model already generated up. Very cool. All right, so we're gonna do the same for the barley. So let's go ahead and open that up again. And in the trees, find the barley, there we go, barley. You wouldn't normally see barley in a forest. If you change the materials, it kind of looks like a cool plant. So it worked. All right, so again, just change that to wavefront OBJ. Choose where it downloads to, desktop. And we're just gonna name that barley.obj. Save. And start. There you go. Back to Blender, and let's go ahead and import again, wavefront OBJ, and there's our barley. There you go. Just like that, we already have our two plant models. So next step is the materials. Okay, so materials. So the materials for our plants. Now we have a main green here for the two plant models. I'll walk you through. So let me just select all of that. Select all of this. Don't worry, I'll re-walk you through all of this. Basically, it's got this main green shader set up here. So, we got a diffuse and we got a translucent mixed together. Basically, the translucent will let light pass through an object using that specified color and mixing it with a normal green diffuse, which I'm actually going to change here a little bit. You always want the translucent to be brighter than the diffuse in most cases. So just go ahead and change that. This material, by the way, will be available in the source files for this. And we're going to mix this mix shader with a glossy, so there's some shine to our plants. But you can also make this on your own. This shader setup, and we're going to mix it together with a normal mix shader at 0.5. So you'll end up getting a material that looks like that. It's just a basic green there. All right, so we're going to apply that to the ends of this as well. Okay, and now these parts are a little bit different. It's got a couple different parts to it. We got like the seeds, and we got these stems from the seeds. So that one, I have a an ends type thing here. And it's literally the exact same node setup. A couple numbers changed, but now it's just white. It's more of a pale white with the diffuse. Mixed together again with the translucent, which is brighter, just a little bit brighter. Still just that tiny bit into the orangey side on the color spectrum. Okay, mixing those together with again a mix shader about 0.7, so it's leaning more towards the translucent. And again a glossy, which is not that bright, with a mix shader of 0.3. So that will get you this kind of pale dark white type thing. So then we'll just apply that to the seeds as well. So shift select that, control L, and link the material. Hopefully I didn't go too fast on that. But yeah, it's just a basic, pretty basic node setup. Okay, so let's go ahead and make this one object, because you can see it has all these different types of things connected. Got the seeds and the other branches, so let's make sure everything has its own material before you hit Control J, so that way it has specified things. As well as this, we'll just make that its own object. Shift select that stem and control J as well. Let's go ahead and move it just to make sure you didn't lose anything. Okay. So now to the scene. Now to make our scene. So we got all the plants done out of the way. Let's go ahead and make our scene. So I'm just gonna move these two guys here to another layer just so they're out of the way. I'm gonna go ahead and add in a plane. Let me just close that. There we go. Add in a plane, holding down control just to scale it up a little bit. Like you saw, it's not that big of an area, so that should be good. And let's go ahead and add in our particle system. So just to make this a little bit easier, we'll just make that a group. Just hit Control G. We don't need to name it because it's going to be the only group in our scene. Let's go ahead and add in a hair. Particle settings, advanced, check random. We're also not going to need that much, about 400, give or take. Just select group and group. Okay. Viewport's going to lag a little bit here, so let me just actually change this to about 20. Okay, there we go. Just so I can see rotations and whatnot. So we want to turn the size for those up. Go ahead and check random size as well. 0.5. Oops. A little more on the size there. Okay. And actually, probably don't even need the 400. Could probably get away with, 100. Yeah. Okay. I mean, you want to make it look thick, but you don't need to go crazy. Yeah, that works. Cool. All right, let's go ahead and set up our lighting in our background. So let's take the default lamp, make it a sun lamp. Let's go ahead and turn the softness of the shadow down to about a 0.03. Check use nodes. Brighten this up just a little bit. Kind of getting that pale sky type thing. Just a little bit of rotation like that. And then just coming across the plants like that. All right. So like I've done in the past, we have the images as planes add-on. I have this by default. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. It just makes it so much easier than having to UV unwrap an image onto a plane and make it an emission material. This thing does it for you, and I love it. So, go to our textures, skies, and actually forest, there we go, and have a couple different ones from around the internet that I found. So this background, if I can find it, because it's been a while since I've downloaded all of these, if I can find it, I'll leave a link in the description to download it. I almost want to say this was on CG textures, but I'm not sure on that. But again, if I can find the texture for this, I'll leave a link. But you can use whatever one you want. But if you're using this add-on, go ahead and check emission for your sky and import images as planes. So just go ahead and scale that up there. Rotate that along the X by 90 degrees. Here we go. All right. So we just want to basically match up this greenery here in the front with this R greenery right there. Okay. And actually, probably doesn't need to be that big. Scale that down a little bit. All right. Let's go ahead and, We'll have to play with it when we get our camera set up. So Control Alt Numpad 0. And we're just going to get a nice shot here. It's kind of like this. Kind of zoom it out a little bit. Yeah, you don't want to get the plane in the shot unless you have a texture for the plane. Just kind of leave that up like that. Okay, I think that that's actually a pretty nice shot. Okay, just rotate that a little bit that way. Okay. Cool. Let's go ahead and move this guy around here a little bit. You want to make that look like it's in the distance as much as you can. So just like that. Sweet. Okay, in the camera settings, let's do some thick depth of field. That's what really sells the scene. Some nice depth of field action. So check limits. And I'm just going to set mine to be about right there. Yeah, basically on this guy right there. Which looks like that's where it is. Okay. So f-stop, and since the distance is so low, you don't need to set this at like 0.2. We could try 1. That may still be a little too thick, but you know, we can test it out. Let's check border rendering, so it only renders what's inside the camera. And have a new preset here for a little bit of widescreen action. And full global illumination. We'll render for the tutorial. I'll just render about 150 samples. I recommend doing, I want to say about 300 to 400, because there is thick depth of field. So depending on how much depth of field you want to use is going to be depending on how many samples you're going to need. So that should be good. Yeah, just doing a little bit of render settings there. All right, go ahead and hit Shift Z, or you can go down here to rendered viewport shading. And it looks great, but I forgot to uncheck something. And that is for that to not cast a shadow and for it to actually cast light. All right, so what I just did is, because you know this is a plane, this is an actual object, it's going to be casting a shadow onto the scene, which it's the sky, so you don't want that to happen. So under the ray visibility, go ahead and uncheck shadow. All right, and I also removed that light path is camera ray. So this is actually casting light onto our scene. With that enabled, it basically makes it a shadeless material. So I always uncheck that so we don't have any problems and it actually casts light. Okay. So should look better now. Shift Z. There you go. You can see our green showing up there a little bit now. We can go ahead and turn that up. Maybe try about 1.5. Just really boosting that. And we can turn our sun lamp here. Be a little bit more. Just rotate it up a little bit. Pretty much having that straight onto the scene there. It's little tweaks that you have to do before you render it out, but I think that actually looks pretty good. You can see the colors in it, and we can adjust the brightness in the node compositor as well. But that is how you create the scene. So let's go ahead and render it out. And oh, you know what? There is one thing that I forgot to do, and that is this. I had some ambient sky lighting, now that I remember it. And I think that's where it's so dark right now. So I'm going to change that to Prethim and just move that around a little bit and turn it down to about 0.5. So we get that nice blue overhead lighting. And there you go. That's where the colors come into play. All right. So let's take it into the compositor and do some sweet action compositing with this. Be back once this is done. Right, so the render finished. It took about 14 minutes. And you can see our nice little result here. So let's make it look a little bit better. Let's hop over to the compositor. And just get set up here. Zoom out our backdrop by hitting V. And yeah, there we go. All right, so you know, it's the basic node setup that we always do. It's a color balance. Just kind of make this look a little more orangey. Then offset that with a little bit of a green, orangey type thing. There you go. Okay. And then next up, we'll go ahead and add in our overall glow to the entire scene. So just change that to low, we'll get a bigger glow. Change that to about 0.2 maybe. Yeah, there we go. Let's try 0.1. Yeah, 0.1. 0.1 works very well. Okay. And then I think other than that, we just add in, you know, the vignette. Let's do a little bit of distortion here with the lens. Just a little bit, though. There we go. It's a little too much. Very slight effect. There we go. Alright, now let's just add in the vignette. Sometimes I try and set records for how fast I can set this thing up since I've done it so many times. If you don't know what I'm doing, I'll walk you back through it. But I pretty much do this for every single tutorial. So, yeah, there's our nice vignette. Okay, so basically for a vignette, you got these four nodes here. Just bring them down away from here. You can skip this part if you know how to do a vignette. But basically, you just distort it. I'll just walk you through it. You distort the image all the way up. You add in a math node to define the black area from the white area. Then you blur out the black area. Using, if you go lower on this, it's going to be more thick, as you can tell. And then you just mix this overall effect into your scene. There you go. That's the vignette. Very rough explanation there, but there you go. And then I always say this for last because the vignette makes it a little bit darker, is the brightness. So I always used to use an RGB curve there just to bump that up just a little bit to get that nice looking effect, and just plug that into your composite. Awesome. We're done. So we got this raw render here, taking it through the compositor. Get you very nice, small little foresty type atmosphere. It's not really a winter scene, but you know, you don't always have to do a winter scene just because it's winter. So I just was looking through my stuff, wanting to see what I should do a tutorial on next, and I came across this one, and I was like, that should be, I think that's still pretty easy, you know, easy enough to create, and it's a nature scene, so. But that is the end of the tutorial, so thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it and you found it helpful. And until next time.